Hello, I'm Mr. Ad-Granth, and lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. I'm not the theologian who went to the university to study the dead letters of the Old and the New Testament. The letters are old wine. And you get drunk with the old wine, desiring not the new. So these university professors, I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. They have no common sense and they just repeat things as their teacher has told them. For example, John the Baptist said, I am baptizing in water. The one coming after me will baptize you in the Holy Spirit. And you can see in the churches, baptizing an infant. And also, in the name of Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, they don't know the difference between Holy Ghost and Holy Spirit. They are spiritually dead people. And they are the ones who are running the churches, and spiritually dead people go there to enjoy the social aspect and not the spiritual one. Over there, the priest was said, bend down and say prayer. What they say, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Our Father is not in heaven. Father lives in his own house, which is this one, not in heaven anymore. So you don't say prayer and fasting. It's not. That's why when we were eating at the Matthew's place, then Pharisees, literally came, hey, your laborers, they call them disciples, because they did not know the difference, that they are not disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline, and the soldiers are disciplined in the army. They are under law, bound. We are not bound, we are free. We are workers, we are laborers, we are solitary, independent, not under the domination of any man, but under the domination of our supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. We are different class and different from priest, royal priest. So bend down and pray, they don't know where our Father is, you know. He's Emmanuel, God is with us. If you're not greedy, if you're cheating people, then God is out and Mammon is in, Satan. The Church of England is the Church of Satan. The soldiers who died in World War I, World War II, they proclaim that they glorified God. And no wonder the Viceroy of India and South Africa, they bring a lot of money to Britain and they built these big cathedrals like St. Paul's Cathedral. And when those Viceroy died, St. Paul's Cathedral said, they glorified God. Salvation are the people, the men of God, who observe agape, unconditional divine love, love everyone, no hatred. They are hated by the Church of England people, as the Jewish rabbi hated the Samaritan, a nation of prophets. So you have to have common sense to know gospel. No common sense, no gospel, simple as that. And then you must have desire, longing for gospel. Gospel is hidden underneath the parable. It is not on the surface. Because it is for those who have discerning intellect, capable of digging out the root of the what is written. So here it is, the idea of this root. It will give you is the what the ideal moral teacher is. Matthew 13 verse 52, with the owner of a house, synagogue, who bring it for 3 years old. This is scripture. You can read the holy book. And they keep, and they kept scrolls in the synagogue. These are the word scrolls. The root of the scripture is oral Torah, which is this one, and which was missing among the Jewish rabbis because they were greedy, but not among the Samaritan rabbis. They were not greedy. So without this one, this is dead. So in the synagogue, they just read the scripture and they can't explain. They can't explain the root of that scripture, which Jesus was explaining in the synagogue. And the people of discerning intellect, the common working man, the shepherd, and the farmers, they appreciated the exposition of Jesus, or explaining the scripture to them, but not those rabbis, dead in letters. They had no idea. They were being jealous, you know. Hey, from this man come. He had no degree in theology. And in Jerusalem, those doctorate of theology and other things, they would not like to talk with Jesus because he had no degree in theology. Same thing. I go to Oxford University. And over there, in one of the halls, they were reading the New Testament on Friday. And I used to attend that one and ask them questions. They could not answer. And I told them there are two gods. One is Devyat, Yahweh, who is the creator of this world. And the one is the real one, who is the father of our souls. They said, no, no, it's the same God. I said, God will, the same God will be jealous and revengeful, which is this one, Daniel to Yahweh, and loving and merciful, which is inside me, living God. No idea. So they wrote to me that you can't attend our seminars. I was just remembering the name of the college. Oh dear. You can't attend our seminars because you have no degree in theology. You should have at least MA or PhD in theology, or a letter from the doc or a priest that you can attend these ones. Recommendation. So that is how they treat you. And in one of the college, Oriel College, they had a seminar on Christian and Jew for 2 days. So I went there a little bit late. I got my badge, everything. I sat in the room listening to the lecture going on. When it finished, a lady called me, come outside. I went to see her. Oh, the students don't like this hoodie, written these things on it. I said, this is the living light on the living lampstand. If somebody likes it, he won't stumble into me. Then he will know what he's going to get. No, no, no. Students don't like it. If you have any plain t-shirt, when they see underneath, it was the same thing, t-shirt, written over it. No, no, you can't attend it. She sent me two strong men to bring my bag from the room and throw me out. So that is how they treat you, and they call you heretic. In the Reading Church, a priest called me heretic. I explained to him the names of the five husbands of the Samaritan woman. They were not physical, they were spiritual, which was calm immorality, crowed anger, lobe greed, more worldly attraction, and the last one was haughtiness, to be proud of its book knowledge as the university professors are. Samaritan woman at the well, she was not well read in the theology, she was just ordinary person, and she waited Jesus in Holy Spirit, because she was not drunk with the old wine, the dead letters. So she exercised Holy Spirit and waited Jesus and called him that you are a prophet. And then when Christ come, he will tell us everything. So she knew the difference between prophet and Christ. So Jesus then told her that I am the Christ. And then she heard that one, she went to her village and told everyone that I found him, but don't believe me, because Christ, you have to find it yourself through logical reasoning. So the whole village went to welcome him, and the whole village became apostles, and still the woman became St.Photina, and still the theologian at the university and other, they call her that she was a prostitute, marrying one husband after the other. So you can see what type of knowledge they have. In the Russian Orthodox Church and Greek, they call her St.Photina. In the British Justice, they call her a prostitute. So that's why the second coming of Jesus took place in India in the name of Nanak in 1469. And he preached gospel through five more rites. That means six Satguru Christ in Sikhism. And still the darkness could not be comprehended. Then one had to use the sword power to suppress the terrorist or cruel people. That was then four of them. Much more in my other videos. So second coming of Jesus had taken place, and people are still expecting for his second coming. This is blindness. So here I'm doing Jesus brewing new wine in Cana, and I'm rendering the exposition of this one, so you know what should be. Before I render it, maybe it's good to know this, the royal kingdom of God, which is above. So this is John the Baptist, ideal rabbi, prophet Elijah. Luke 16 verse 16, law and prophets are till John the Baptist. So scripture finished here. Old wine finished here. There is the new wine here. So this, he baptized them in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. Mary was surrogate mother. She was sired by Yahweh. That's why the name of the son was Yeshua. Yeah, from Yahweh. Shua or Shiva means the primordial Adam, first Adam. Jesus was second Adam. So that seed had to be buried here to turn it into plant, because seed can't bear fruit. The same way when you sow a wheat plant, you put the wheat seed in the soil, then it germinates a plant. And that plant, you can see by appearance that it is wheat plant. So the identity of the seed becomes implicit, and the spiritual identity plant is explicit. So that plant then is twice born, enter through this narrow gate, here solitary basis, with a word of sadhus, natural they took. So here we have one father, we are all his children, sons. That's why we are fishes of men and no woman here. So when you craft yourself to the true vine, cried Jesus, to have your daily living bread. And then you take it to your heart, digest it with the teeth of logical reasoning, to do logo in honor of Christ Jesus, to glorify our Father. Much more in my other videos. So let's carry on, you know, otherwise it will become too long. So there you are. I've written something over here in the second coming of Jesus. He told Nanak, this age, dark age, what is this one? What time is this one? He said, PAVANN. PAVANN PAVANN means wind. When we speak, you know, the wind vibrates and it's conveyed to the other one, you hear it just one. It is not material, immaterial, or the revelation. PAVANN. SATGUR MAT VAILA. SATGUR means Christ, in the time of Christ, in the dark age. SHABD GURU, His word is our teacher. Whatever comes from the mouth of Christ Jesus, you have to eat the flesh of Jesus, take it to your heart, digest it logically, you do no good. SHABD GURU, SURATT being common sense. SURATT DHUNN CHAELA. So common sense in you is the disciple of our Supernatural Father. So, many things are written, but you can find it. So here, I'm holy gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi, my native language, we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that dwells in his temple. This is the most beautiful temple of God. Our physical body, created not by the human hands, but by the demiurge potter, the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, etc. Represented by angel, prophet Elijah, John the Baptist. My God is Yahweh. And it is called Harmandir. Harman, the temple of God. Har means God, Mandir means temple. And our Emmanuel, God is with us. If God is with us, before the things come to your mouth as we do in prayer, He already knows. So there's no need to blah, blah, blah. And the prayers are waste of time. Or Emmanuel, according to St. John 2, verse 1 to 11. There was a wedding at Cana in Galilee. And the surrogate mother of Jesus, Mary, was there. Jesus and his brethren, and not the once born disciples of the rabbis. So Jesus had no disciples, twice born laborers of brethren, co-workers, were also invited to the wedding. When the old wine ran short, old wine is the scripture, law and prophets, what telling John the Baptist. Luke 16 verse 16, that means that the law and prophets finished by John the Baptist. The surrogate mother of Jesus said to him, They have no wine, no law and order, as they found in the time of Jesus. That is why those people who came to Jesus, but they were shepherdless. They were righteous people being cheated by the clever people, as Lazarus was cheated by the rich man. And he was sitting at the door of the rich man, and he won't look after him, not to dress his wounds. Wounds are licked by dogs. Same with the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person. Two greedy rabbi and Pharisee, they passed by. They did not bother to help or pick him up. But a Samaritan man with no love of money, he picked him up and looked after him. Man of God. And Jesus said to her, woman, how does your concern affect me? That means it is not you people that affect me. My hour has not yet come. It is the hour when it comes, then I will do my way. That is the dark ages of Christ. Law was so much misused that people got fed up. Remember that under Jewish view, people, if a Jew cheat a Jew, then they go to the rabbi to get it settled. And if a Jew cheat a Gentile, then a Jew cannot stand a witness against the Jew. That means what Jesus said, let the crook, they stay together, otherwise the kingdom will fall. So the crook rabbi, they were standing together against Christ Jesus. And so is this today, the law and these ombudsmen, they are the defense solicitors for their client, and the public is cheated, and they are running a mafia, and nobody is bothered. My hour has not come yet. Law was so much misused that people got fed up with the corruptions. So much corruption going on. There are so many corruptions as today we have in this society. Law is the old wine. His surrogate mother said to the servants, do whatever he tells you. Now, there were 6 stone water jars there for Jewish ceremonial washings, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, fill the jars with water. Now 20 to 30 has a meaning behind it. 20, the 10 are once more, 20 is twice more, but doubting, 30 is twice born and sealed to serve God. So that is what the 20-30 mean. Those who are twice born, some are doubting, some are sealed to serve God. Okay. Sarvadi, whatever he tells you. Now there are 6 stone water jars. Remember, menorah has 7 candles, 6 of Yahweh, the middle one is of Elohim. There are Jewish ceremonial washings, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, fill the jars with water. Now they rinsed out the specks of the old wine first. Old wine means the dead letters. That finished with John the Baptist, Luke 16 verse 16. So they put in the fresh water, the time of Christ. So they filled these in his, so they filled them to the brim so that no room was left for the old wine. That means people should have clean heart, like those of the shepherd in the field to whom the good news was given about the birth of Jesus, and not to the deadened letters, the jars full of old wine and at the Jerusalem temple, theologians. It wasn't given to them. So, was left for the old wine, the dead letters, the script, no money in your pocket, no two shoes, no two tunic, and no script. Script means the Bible. Bible is forbidden by Christ. These are the Jewish level. The heart of the hard-working shepherds tending their sheep, they will get the gospel. That is, the gospel is received by the illiterate people possessing common sense, like the farmers in the field. They don't cheat people in the villages. They are honest, you know. So, tending, that is the gospel received by the initiated people possessing common sense called Holy Spirit, and not received by the men of the dead letters, university professors of theology that have no common sense. And he told them, the illiterate shepherd, he told the illiterate shepherd to whom the good news was broken, draw some out now and take it to the head waiter. So they took it there. So they took it, and when the head waiter tasted the water that had become wine without knowing where it came from, through revelations received by the common man, not the university professors or literature, from revelation seeking the new wine. Although the servers are apostles who had drawn the water, knew, so they knew where from it came, because the gospel received on individual basis and not like in a class or anything like that. That gate is narrow and low for the solitary. Then you enter the royal kingdom where you get the new wine. The head waiter called the bridegroom, Christ Jesus, in whose honor we preach the gospel to glorify our supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., and said to him, everyone serves good wine first, as at the time of Moses. At the time of Moses, these rabbis, they were not corrupt so much as later on they became. That's why the rabbis of Joseph, the relation of Joseph, whom the 11 brothers sold as a slave, they remained in that character. And they kept the Torah in good shape, no corruption in that one. But the other 11 brothers, generation, they corrupted the Torah. So much more I can tell in detail, you know. And said to him, everyone serves good wine first, as at the time of Moses, when the rabbis were not corrupt, and then when the people have drunk freely or stuck deep into the dead letters. Dead letters, you know, they are reading Torah, as you can see them today. They read Torah with shaking their head and all that, you know. An inferior one, then corruptions crept into the scriptures. Scriptures were corrupted by the rabbis at the Jerusalem, the husbandmen's. But you have kept the good wine until now, served only to the people. Oh dear. Only to the people desiring the gospel truth through logical reasoning in this dark age, in this dark age of Christ, of the Holy Spirit, which is common sense, and not served in the not served to the Christians of the dead, Christians dead in the letters. Christians without Bible, you know, they can't say a word. If you ask them some question, they open the Bible and they quote you a verse, cross-reference, take you there, quote you. You get fed up with them. That is not gospel. Gospel comes from here. So they have nothing in here. All in the dead book, which is corruption. They are not Christ, they are Christians of the dead letters, good for nothing. Jesus did this as the beginning of his signs in Cana. Signs mean that it is the age of Christ. In Cana, in Galilee, so revealed his glory, and his brother began to believe in him. So that's where he revealed who he is, his purpose into this world. And our Father God blesses you. And it is very simple. Gospel is like ABC. So far you can think logically. Our Father blesses you in agape, unconditional divine love, in which we hate none, but we love all.